Hello from Berlin, Germany. My name is Alina Dima, and I'm a senior developer advocate in the AWS IoT service team. In this video, I will show you how to securely connect to your remote IoT device using secure tunneling from browser, a feature of AWS IoT Device Management and the open source AWS IoT Device Client. So why do we need secure tunneling? Well, IoT devices are remote and need to be managed and monitored remotely in a secure manner. Using firewalls is a common way to protect and secure access to your IoT devices. Yet, it's challenging to access and manage devices deployed at remote sites behind firewalls that block all inbound traffic. If something goes wrong, troubleshooting these devices can involve sending technicians on site to connect. This increases the complexity and the cost of device management. AWS IoT introduced secure tunneling a while back, which allowed you to connect to the destination device using proxy connections through the command line interface at the source device. But this required installing a local proxy on the operator's device, which was effort and cost. With a new browser-based feature of AWS IoT Device Management, you can connect to your destination devices right from the embedded SSH terminal through the AWS console without the need for a local proxy from the source device. This feature improves the onboarding experience significantly by eliminating the need to compile and install a local proxy on the operator's device. And this is what this demo today is going to show you. So let's talk a little bit about how it works. The first step is for the device to subscribe to the AWS designated topic for receiving the access token. The AWS IoT Device Client already provides an AWS IoT C++ SDK component which subscribes to this topic. As a next step, the operator will create the secure tunnel, either using the AWS console or the AWS CLI. During the creation of the tunnel, AWS IoT Device Management will instruct AWS IoT Core to publish a notify MQTT message, and AWS IoT Core will send the destination access token to the device. The AWS IoT Device Client will take care of initializing the local proxy component and establish the destination connection. The browser-based secure tunneling feature of AWS IoT Device Management will take care of opening the source connection from the AWS IoT Device Management console. As a next step, the operator can open the SSH connection to the device via the embedded terminal in the AWS IoT Device Management console. And this is what we will see a little later in the demo. So let's look at the prerequisites. For this demo, you will need to have an AWS IoT thing with a unique device identity, meaning certificate, private key, and the root CA located on your device. It is also a prerequisite that you have installed and compiled the AWS IoT Device Client. You can find the exact instructions around compiling and installing the AWS IoT Device Client at the provided link in GitHub. We are going to follow in this demo a step-by-step approach. So firstly, we are going to set up the AWS IoT Device Client, which will be running as a service with a needed secure tunneling component. Then we will create the AWS IoT Secure Tunnel in the AWS console and connect to our IoT device using the newly created tunnel. So let's get started. As a first step, you can see that I have created an AWS IoT thing called Demo Device. I am logged into the box that has the AWS IoT Device Client already cloned from GitHub, and I will show you that the unique device identity is also located on the device in the correct folder. This is important so that the AWS IoT Device Client knows where to find the certificates for the device. So let's have a look. So you can see that the CA certificate, the unique device certificate, and the private key are located here. Now we are going to configure the AWS IoT Device Client. For this, we're actually going to need to run the setup script. If we want to run the AWS IoT Device Client as a service, we need to run the script either as root or via sudo. Now, let's start the AWS IoT Device Client as a service. So yes, we want to interactively generate the configuration file. Now we need to look on the AWS console and see our IoT endpoint and copy it. As a next step, we need to copy the path to our device certificate file. Then we can copy the path to the certificate to the private key file and the path to the root CA. Next step is to specify our thing name, and our thing is called, let's look again, not to make a mistake, demo device. Yes, we would like to configure the logger. We can leave the default configuration. We would like to put the log in a file. The location is correct. Yes, we would like SDK logging, and we leave the default. We also leave the default path. We don't want to enable jobs, but we do want to enable the secure tunneling. We don't want to enable the device defender feature for now, and we also don't want to enable the fleet provisioning, nor do we want to enable the pub sub or the shadow. This is because we are only going to test the tunnel. So we can leave the configuration where it is actually located right now. So this is under etc. It's important to remember this configuration. So for now we click yes. Do we want to copy the job handlers to specify directory? Yes, we can do that. We want to install it as a service. And yes, we do want to install it as a service. The complete directory path, we can leave it as the build directory where we have actually built our AWS IoT device client. So let's leave the default. And we don't want to run Valgrind, so we should put no. And as you can see, already the AWS IoT device client is running at the moment. So we have managed with this step. So let's get out of this terminal and let's see that actually our service is running. So for this, we do sudo service AWS IoT device client status. And we see that our client is actually running. We can also have a look at the logs. So var log AWS IoT device client. Let's do a less here. So let's read the AWS IoT client log. We need to read it with sudo. Oops. We need to add the less. So here we see our entire configuration, and we also see all the logs inside. So now is the right time to actually start creating our tunnel. So if we go on our AWS IoT thing, we can go straight here and we can click on create tunnel. So this brings us to the interface for creating a new tunnel. Because we don't have an existing tunnel, we want to create a new one. And we also want to go via the quick setup for SSH. So here it's the tunnel details. So the target device is correct. And as you can see, the minimum, the tunnel duration is maximum 12 hours. So we click confirm and create. And we see that this allows us to download the tokens. So download the access token for the source and the access token for the destination. So the destination is our device, and the source is going to be the AWS IoT console. We don't need to store any of these tokens because already the destination token has been sent via MQTT message for the device client, and we are going to be using this terminal window, so we don't need the access token for the source. So we can click done, and we see that we have a tunnel in a disconnected state. So now the next step is to click on connect, and we're going to be using private key. And we're going to be using our username, which is Ubuntu. And let's choose the private key as well. So the private key is our demo private key. And now we can connect. Right, so as you can see here on the screen, we are already connected to our device with this terminal, and we can now basically have a look just on this terminal. We can make it bigger so that we can have a better look. And here we can start, for example, looking at the AWS device client logs, right? So if we go var log, and now we go sudo let's AWS device client and the AWS device client log. So here we can see that the entire configuration has been set up, and now I am basically waiting for data. So I'm basically tailing the log. So this is, yeah, so this shows you that we the tunnel has, the DCP tunnel has been successfully established and that it's, everything is working. Right, so this concludes our demo. With this tunnel open, now we can perform any kind of configuration changes that we need to do for the device in order to see if anything is wrong on the device. Thank you for joining me in the video today. As a recap, we have gone through a step-by-step approach to configure the AWS IoT device client, to run the AWS client, device client as a service, create our AWS IoT secure tunnel in the AWS console, and ultimately, we have connected to our IoT device using the recently created AWS IoT secure tunnel. If you would like to find out more information about how this works, you can have a look at the AWS IoT device client in our GitHub repository under AWS Labs, AWS IoT device client. So the device client is open source, so you can use it and contribute to it as well. The secure tunneling from browser is described in the latest AWS IoT developer guide. And there is also a step-by-step blog post on how to implement and configure your secure tunneling. Thank you very much for watching the video today. And if you would like to connect with me, feel free to scan the QR code and connect with me on LinkedIn or Twitter. Thank you again from Berlin and have a nice rest of the day.